Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 14th video class of DIP, we will study histogram specification or matching and its implementation in MATLAB. So as usual, starting with the name itself. Why? Because everything is there in the name. What is the meaning of histogram? Histogram is the graphical representation of the image data. What is the meaning of specification? Specification means to specify something from the very beginning. That means we will be specifying what type of histogram we want from the very beginning. And matching means we'll be matching the histogram of the problem image with some reference image. So let us start. So in the previous video class, we studied histogram equalization, that is histogram flattening, and we concluded at the end that histogram equalization is not always good and it is automatic. It is non-interactive, that is it always gives only one result, an approximation of a uniform histogram. But many a times it is desirable to have an interactive method in which certain gray levels are highlighted. It should be noted that if we modify the gray level of an image that have a uniform PDF using the inverse transformation, we get back the original image. So exploiting this knowledge, we can obtain any shape of the gray level histogram by processing the given image, and the method used to generate a processed image that has a specified histogram is called histogram specification or histogram matching. So this figure shows the image of a Mars moon. So you can see that the image is very dark and very important portions of the image towards this side are not visible. And you can see that the majority of the pixels are concentrated towards the zero or black of the image. And we know that this 0 means black and 255 means white. So now if you histogram equalize this image using the procedure that we studied in the previous video class, this will be the transfer function of the histogram equalization. So say output intensity S is equal to T of R, it is transfer function of R. So after histogram equalization, we obtain an image like this. So you can see that histogram equalization is not working good over here, and the image that is obtained is a washed out image. And this figure shows the histogram of this washed out image. Now instead of using histogram equalization, if we specify the histogram that is to be applied to this image like this from the very beginning, that is, you can say that this is our reference transfer function, that is S is equal to G of Z. So if we equalize this reference transfer function, we obtain the histogram equalization of the reference transfer function like this S curve 1, which is shown over here and is represented by G of ZQ is equal to SK. And if we take the inverse histogram values of curve 1, we obtain curve 2, which is specified by ZQ is equal to G inverse of SK. So using this inverse mapping, the histogram that we obtain is like this, and the image that we obtain using histogram specification is like this. So you can see from this image that now the portions towards the darker side are also visible properly, and you can compare this histogram specified image with the histogram equalized image of this. So as compared to this washed out image, this image is a very good image for analysis, and this is known as histogram specification or histogram matching. Let us understand this histogram matching mathematically using one example. So this is your problem image, that is image A, and this image B is your reference image. So you have to match the histogram of image B to image A. So very first step that we'll be doing is we'll be plotting the histogram for image A and image B like this, and we'll be performing histogram equalization for image A as well as image B as explained in the previous video class. So when you equalize image A, these are the new gray levels that you obtain, and these are new pixel values. And remember that you have to note down the new pixel values because we'll be using these new pixel values after the final mapping. Now as we equalize image A, similarly we equalize image B and obtain the new gray level values, and we are not interested in writing the new pixel values for image B. Why? Because we'll be mapping the new gray level values with the pixel values of image A, that is our problem image. So you can note that the number of pixels for image B and image A both are same, that is 4096. So after you obtain the new gray level values for image B, the next step is to note down the gray level values or new gray level values of image A and image B. So how to note it down? Please remember properly. First of all, note down the gray level values, that is from 0 to 7, and the new gray level values for image A, that is 1, 3, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 7. 1, 3, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 7. In the next column, note down the equalization values of the reference image. So the equalization values or new gray level values are 0, 0, 0, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. 0, 0, 0, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. Now only concentrate on this column and this column. So using these two columns, we will note down the mapping for histogram specification. So very first value in second column is 1. So now find out where 1 is occurring in the third column. So 1 is occurring over here. So for 1, what is the gray level value? For 1, the gray level value is 3. For 1, the gray level value is 3. So you have to note down 3 in the mapping. Next value in the second column is 3. So find out whether 3 is occurring in this third column or not. Yes, it is occurring. So it is occurring over here. So for 3, what is the value? The value is 4. So you have to note down 4 in the mapped values. Okay. So if 1 is present over here and 1 is not present over here, then you have to take the next value, that is 2. Similarly, for 3, if 3 is not present over here, you need not take 2, but you have to take the next value, that is 4. Okay. So histogram equalization level of the target histogram has to be greater than the original histogram. Remember this. Next value that is occurring is 5. So is 5 occurring in this third column? Yes, it is occurring over here. And what is the value for 5? For the 5, value is 5 itself. Okay. So for 5, the value is 5 itself, and we will note down 5 in the mapped values. Next value is 6. Is 6 is occurring? Yes, 6 is occurring over here. So for 6, the gray level is 6. So we'll note down 6. Next again it is 6. So again we will write 6. Next is 7. 7 is occurring in the third column. Yes, 7 is occurring over here. And for 7, the value is 7. So we'll note down 7. Again for 7, 7. Again for 7, 7. So now these are the new mapping for histogram specification. So remember, there are no mappings for 0, 1 and 2. So 0, 1 and 2 will be 0, right? And the values will start from 3. And now you have to take the values of the equalized histogram of original image. That is 790, 1023, 850, 985, 448, right? So we'll start with 790. So I will choose a different pen. So for 3, the new pixel value will be 790. Remember, there are no values for 0, 1 and 2 for the mapping. So 0, 1 and 2 will be 0. It starts with 3. So very first value is 790. So we'll note down 790 over here. Next for 4, the next value over here is 1023. So now note down the gray levels, that is 0 to 7, as it is a 3-bit image, and the number of pixels. So as there are no pixels for 0, 1 and 2, it is 0, 0, 0. For 3 it is 790, for 3 it is 790, for 4 it is 1023, for 4 it is 1023, for 5 it is 850, for 5 it is 850, for 6 it is 985, so for 6 it is 985, and for 7 it is 448, so for 7 it is 448. And plot the final histogram. So this is your resultant histogram. Okay, so what we have done here, we have done the inverse mapping, that is the inverse of the output values is mapped to the input values for histogram matching. Now you can compare the resultant histogram and our reference histogram, and you can see that both these histograms are matching. That means we have done histogram matching or histogram specification. That is, we have matched the histogram of our original image to the reference image, and this is known as histogram specification or histogram matching. So when we perform the histogram specification in MATLAB, you obtain the result like this. So this is our input image, which is a RGB image with color cast, that is some unwanted tint of color. This image is produced when one of the color channels is not working. And this is the histogram of that particular problem image. And you want to histogram match this image with this reference color image. So after histogram matching, you will obtain the output image like this. And you can compare the histogram of the reference image with the histogram of the enhanced image, and both are matching, you can see, as compared to the problem image. When you perform the same histogram matching with the inbuilt MATLAB images, that is cameraman and tire, this is the histogram match image that we obtain. And you can see the histograms of the reference image and enhanced image are matching. Let us perform this in MATLAB. So this program shows histogram matching or specification. We are reading our problem image, that is Concord Arial.png, and our reference image, that is Molik.png, and using imHistMatch, matching the histogram of the reference image into the problem image and storing in B. And then I am subplotting my problem image, that is the image with color cast, reference color image, and the histogram match image. And I am also plotting the histogram of all the three using imHist. So let us run this program and see the output. If you highlight this particular portion in the problem image and the histogram matched image, you can see how nicely all the colors are recovered properly or matched properly with the reference color image. So now it is not a washed out image like this. And also you can compare the histograms. You can see the histogram of the problem image was like this, and the reference image is like this, and the histogram of enhanced image or histogram matched image is matching with the reference color image. Let us perform the same program using inbuilt MATLAB images, that is cameraman and tire. This one is the histogram match image, and you can see that the histogram of the final image is matching with the reference image. So in this way, we can solve the problem that occurred for histogram equalization using histogram matching or histogram specification. So that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.